Hi, this is the Daily Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now today, let's look at some of the ways you can examine the optimization of other apps on Google Play. All right, so a couple weeks ago, I was having a conversation with somebody about ASO, and we were talking about the main tenets of ASO, the title, the description, the keyword research, all that kind of stuff. And he came back to me and asked about some of the apps that were ranking really well on Google Play and said, hey, how come this app over here is doing really well for these keywords, but the keyword isn't in the title or in the description that much? Or it's in the title, but it's not that much in the description, and there's other apps with the same title in the same description. Right, so I thought, well, let's look at it, because there's so many factors that you can't see immediately, right? And it turned out that this application had like tens of thousands of reviews. It was like it had obviously millions of downloads, so it was doing really well, right? And I didn't even look to see how many backlinks were going to the Google Play page. There's so many different factors at play, and all you had to do was point out a few of them to see why they were doing really well, as opposed to the other ones. You could compare them that way. Now, it's not an exact science, because we don't understand exactly how the search algorithm works, but we know some of the things that are important because Google tells us that they're important, like having a lot of backlinks that go to your page with those keywords in them, having it in your title. Having reviews is perfect, because you got to think about how Google Play works. Like, they want, like, when you're searching for something, they want to give you the best thing possible. That way you continue to use it. So they're going to base that based on the reviews. So if I'm going for a keyword, let's say I'm going for the keyword spy, which I do, and I release a new app, and there's another one out there that's got 100,000 reviews, positive or negative, then my new one, just because I put spy in the title, is not necessarily going to work, right? So. And another tool that I use is the Wayback machine to look at, because that keyword might not be in the title anymore. So let me show you something here that I know I've mentioned this before, but one of the tools that I use, and when I was researching this one, is the Wayback machine, which you probably know about if you want to look at what web pages look like way back in the day. So first of all, have a look at my screen over here. Let's take a look at Google Play. I'm going to do the thing I do. I've done this in so many videos, I know, but I'm going to type in my search term here, which is spy, and I used to come in first. Ear Agent is my app here. I used to come in first all the time, and now this other one's come up first, but so at first that was bothering me a little bit, but I don't have spy in the title anymore. It used to be called Ear Spy, and I changed it to Ear Agent, so the other one has spy in the title. It's got a lot of downloads, all that kind of stuff, so fair play to it. But if I show you over on App Annie under the ASO section, in the US, I still got the top slot there. So, I'm not too worried yet, but eventually someone's gonna knock me off the top spot for that keyword. So anyway, so if you have a look at my description here, you see we removed spy from the title, last year. It's been over a year now. And we've removed it from everywhere. It's still in the screenshots, but that's not being indexed. So, and we only have the word spy once here in the description. So we removed it from everywhere else. So, but it's still ranking really well. Now, the reason for this is because we have a whole lot of reviews. We've had 40,000 reviews, nearly 41,000 reviews. They're not all positive, but a lot of them mention the word spy. We also have links all over the place that are pointing to the word, that links going to Ear Spy from, that we've put out there, that other people who've reviewed the application have put out there, and they all have the word spy in it, and all those links are coming into Google Play there too. So that's helping a lot. Right, there's lots of different factors at play here. Now, if you're not sure, so if I show you, if you're trying to look at an application and try to come up with theories as to why they're doing so well, one of the tools that I use a lot is the Wayback machine, because things could have changed in the title. Like I said, mine used to have the word spy in the title, and it doesn't anymore. It's still ranking for the word spy, so if you were just coming across it now and you didn't know that, you might be thinking, what's going on here? Why is why is that working? So if I just take the copy of the URL here and go to the Wayback machine, which is archive.org/web, and I paste in my history. And those of you guys who know how this works and everything, you're not going to be too surprised, but You see, you know, the first occurrence of this was back in 2013. It was released in 2012, but the first one we have here is 2013. I'll go in, the first snapshot we have of it is June. Here we go. And so you should be able to see like my very pathetic first description and install here. So we got the old style Google Play. We've got my thing up here at the top, and we've got my screenshot. So we've got my description. And I think back then I was asking people to leave. I may have been asking people to click on ads, which I quickly found out I wasn't allowed to do. So I removed that. Right. So, but you can see my screenshots here. Like, let me just, this is something we need to talk about more, because this is another big thing that a lot of people aren't doing. They're including screenshots that are just of their app. So here, you see back in the early days, I'd have three screenshots. One was, you know, Ear Spy on, or Ear Spy off, Ear Spy on, and the Save As dialogue that pops up, right? Not too many ratings, but it was what it was. So, you know, if you go back here, you'll see the word spy all over the place. You'll see these terrible screenshots. And of course, you know, our downloads really picked up when we started, you know, optimizing things a lot better. So I put the backlinks out there. That was really big, but that's such a difficult one to measure. Like, you just, you know, I find it difficult to measure. And we you know, the nice video up here. And if somebody hits on this page, we want them to see exactly what the app does, not, you know. One of the things that I found early on was that nobody reads the descriptions, but they'll look at the screenshots. And if they can't figure out from the screenshots what the thing does, then they probably will just move on, right? And you could tell that from your analytics on Google Play. You can see, like, if you have a lot of people visiting the page, but not a lot of downloads, you can say you have to work on your screenshots and all that kind of stuff. Then, and screenshots, they're part of the ASO, they're part of the whole thing, the methodologies and stuff like that, but they're not the early part. So the first bit is being found in search, you know, people actually learning about your app. But once they do and they get to this page, you know, and they don't download, there's something wrong with the page. You have to go through and think what's not enticing about that. And one of the things that we did on all of ours was having annotated screenshots. So not just the screenshots of the app itself, but actually what it does, and some, you know, some nice big bold claims and all that kind of stuff. So anyway, so if you're trying to reverse engineer another application and see how they're being so successful, and again, there's things there that you might not even be able to see. Like, there's some things you could pick out, but, you know, they could have been mentioned by a major blogger. Like, you know, with Flappy Birds, it was the fact that PewDiePie played it and everybody ran to it, right? There's nothing to do with ASO or anything like that, and that became huge, right? Or it could be, you know, it could have been in the news, it could have been related to something topical at the time, and it got that momentum to get started, or they could have just been spending a lot on ads for it. So anyway, I hope that helps a little bit. Do you have any other tools that you guys use if you try to reverse engineer this kind of stuff? I'd be really interested to know. And anyway, that's it for today. I'll talk to you guys tomorrow.